Hey everybody, welcome to Kid City Online. We are so excited that you chose to join us here today online. Now, having said that, we would love to see you live and in person, 8:30, 10:30 on Sundays. We are taking precautions to make sure you're safe, make sure things are sanitized, and make sure that you're gonna have fun. But until you're ready, we're gonna continue to be here for you online. As you know, we started a new series, Big and Strong, and it's amazing. I've been just getting excited and thinking about working out myself. Check it out. All right, I got work to do, but that's all right. But listen, we're gonna get in our lesson. It's gonna be amazing, so focus. We're gonna have some praise and worship by Ethan and our praise team. So hey, let's have some praise and worship, okay?
Speak to my weary heart, strengthen my broken parts, lead me to your open arms. Word of truth, illuminate all these lies. The enemy speaks inside, and freedom I will rise. 'Cause you called me out.
Awesome praise and worship, guys. You're getting so much better, man. I love it. But listen, hey, it's time for our story. All about being big and strong. No matter how small you feel or you are, with God, you can be big and strong because He is a big God. So let's get right into our story. Are you ready? Hit it!
Slapstick Theater. Gideon's 300 men. This is Gideon.
Hey!
Who was a judge of Israel. In the time when Gideon lived, a group of people called the Midianites were taking over the Israelites' land.
Get out of here!
And the Israelites were starving.
Yeah!
So the Israelites asked God for help. God chose Gideon to rescue the Israelites.
Hey, everybody!
And gave him the power to lead an army of Israelites.
Yeah!
One day, Gideon and his army got up early and came close to the Midianite camp. God told Gideon that he had too many warriors with him.
Really?
So God told Gideon to let all the men who were scared go home.
All right, you can go home.
Phew.
So 22,000 men went home, and Gideon was left with only 10,000. But God told Gideon that he still had too many men with him.
What, really?
He told Gideon to bring the men down to the water, and that God would give them a test.
Okay.
Gideon did as God asked, and then God said, "Divide the men in two groups. In one group, put all those who cup water in their hands and lap it up with their tongues like dogs. In the other group, put those who kneel down and drink with their mouths in the stream." Only 300 men drank from their hands. God told Gideon, "With these 300 men, I will rescue you and give you victory over the Midianites. Send all the others home." So Gideon did as God said.
You can go home.
That night, God told Gideon to get up and go down to the camp to listen to what the Midianites were saying.
Hey, Pura, let's go!
Gideon and his servant Pura went down to the camp and saw the huge army. There were too many men and camels for Gideon to even count.
Whoa, that's a lot of camels.
But Gideon heard a soldier telling another man about a dream he had that showed them that God would give Gideon victory over the Midianites. When Gideon heard this, he worshipped God.
Come on!
Then Gideon and his army of 300 men went down to the Midianite camp. They blew their horns and held torches in their hands. They yelled out, and the Midianite soldiers rushed around in a panic and tried to escape. Then God caused the Midianites to start fighting against each other. Because of God's power, Gideon and his army had victory over the Midianites that day.
Amazing story, right? But now let's talk to Greg and see what he's got going on about getting big and strong, okay? Greg, where you at? Oh, hey. Over to you, my friend.
Ah! Woo! Hey everybody, I'm Greg, and this is Big and Strong. For the last few years, I've been lazy. I've been sitting on my couch, eating junk food, and playing video games. But today is a new day. All the hard work starts here, going to the gym. So follow me, Greg, and my cameraman, Dan, as we start this incredible transformation. Come on, Dan, we're going to the gym. Big and strong, big and strong. Come on, Dan. Hey friends, so as you know, we're still on the mission to get big and strong. I came up with a genius idea today thanks to the help of my cameraman, Dan. Why not lose excess body fat by sweating? So I went online and bought a state-of-the-art sweatsuit to make sure I lose all the body fat I can so I can get big and strong faster. So Dan, let's set up in the sun and let the sweating begin. Ah, it's not too bad. Oh, all right. Oh, it's pretty bad, Dan. It's kind of making me sleepy. Hello? Oh, Tabor. Yeah, I'm just sweating it out right now in the sun. I forgot that was today. I'm on my way. Come on, Dan. Yeah.
103, 104, 105, 106, 106.
Cameron!
Hey! Yeah! Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Yeah! Guys, guys, I'm here in Tabor and Cameron's mom's garage right now. These are my personal trainers. Not only that, they're some of my good friends. How you guys doing?
Oh, we're good.
Good.
That's right.
Cameron and I's number one passion is
fitness. And Joey has the right idea right now. Not exactly the right approach, as you can see. Before you build muscle, you have to burn fat.
Back me up, bro. That's right, Taves. This sweatsuit here is just not gonna cut it.
Why not?
We prescribe you for good old-fashioned cardio.
What? Well, I don't want running. What? I don't want to do cardio. I want to do weightlifting. I want to get big and strong.
Exercise isn't about cool machines or weights or a personal gym in your mom's garage.
What? What's it about?
It's about your body.
Okay.
And what's in here? Let's go on that run.
Wait. I don't want to go on the run.
Red Bull, have less. 12, 30. We're out.
Big and strong, guys.
Sick, bro.
Big and strong.
Solid, Greg. All solid. Right.
I think I got it.
Almost there.
Eye of the tiger, baby.
So just keep running. That's the plan, right?
That's the point. Keep on running.
Okay. Let's go a little faster. I think I can do it.
Let's all go right. A little faster. Yeah.
Boosting up.
Okay. All right, get it close.
I'm saying, bro.
Big almost crossed the finish line.
Come on. Okay, what do we
you're
got?
Almost there. Almost there.
God. Yes!
Wow. 23 minutes and 13 seconds, straight drop,
bro!
Oh, you can do it, buddy! You know you can do it!
Okay!
Hey, bro,
okay.
We're gonna go get lunch!
Alright, we're gonna get some lunch! See you later, bud!
Woo! Now I know why they call that thing a sweatsuit. That was one of the hardest things I've done, but I learned a lot, and thanks to Cameron and Tabor, I think I'm a good runner now. But today, I got a story for you. And it's about a true big and strong guy from the Bible. But he wasn't always that way. Gideon was kind of a nobody at the start of the Bible. Now, God told Gideon that he would lead the Israelites to victory over the Midianites. Gideon couldn't believe that God wanted to use him. But after a series of signs from God, Gideon agreed to lead Israel. He assembled an army of 32,000 men. But God said that 32,000 was too many soldiers. Through a series of tests, God narrowed the army down from 32,000 men to just 300. 300 Israelites against tens of thousands of Midianites? But that's exactly what God wanted. God ordered that Gideon and his men sneak up on the Midianites with horns and jars. When the night came, they shouted, blew their horns, and shattered their jars. The Midianites were terrified, and in the chaos, they began to flee and attack one another. Before long, all the Midianites were gone. God was able to do all of that with just 300 men. But the truth is, he could have done it with any number. God works through us to accomplish great things, but all the power is his. It's like with exercise. God doesn't need strong people any more than I need all this cool workout technology. But what God wants is our hearts to be willing. Gideon was completely unsure of himself, but he was obedient, and God used him to defeat a huge army. And his story didn't stop there. Gideon went on to be a judge and a prophet who accomplished lots of other great things. Our lives could look a lot like that too. We don't need to be strong or even brave for God to use us. We just have to trust him. Now, faith in God empowers us to do things that we never could do on our own strength. It might look different for us than it did for Gideon, but we worship the same God, and he wants greatness for all of us. Now, it might mean becoming a missionary, or a doctor, or it could just mean being a good friend to people who need one. We never have to be afraid to obey God, because he's more powerful than anything in this world. So this week, go to God in prayer, and see if he's calling you to do anything. And while you're at it, try to eat healthy, and get some exercise. I gotta go put on that sweatsuit and do another run. So, thanks for watching Big and Strong, and remember, be encouraged, get motivated, and have a great week. We'll see you guys later.
Wow, thanks Greg for that interesting way to show us about being big and strong, and explain how Gideon had to trust in God, even though it ended up being a very small army, God used it to do something big and defeat the enemy. Always trust in God. Always believe. No matter what your circumstances, God is always bigger than what you're going through. We love you guys, and we want to see you back on campus if you're comfortable. But listen, online, 8:30, 10:30, we'll be here for you. God bless, and we'll see you next week.